Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive and GI Plus. Welcome to this lesson brought to you by Elixir Strings, where we're going to discuss how you can customise the sound of your acoustic guitar. Now, much effort and energy is spent on tweaking and customising the sounds of our electric guitars by swapping pickups out, changing pedals and amplifiers, and sometimes even cables. And that is a fine way to adjust the way your electric guitar sounds. But for acoustic guitars, that level of electronic wizardry is really just not available to us. However, there are lots of steps we can take to get the absolute best sound out of your acoustic guitar. And we are going to begin by discussing some technical issues, just to get them out of the way, because we want to kind of remove any possibility of user error, some technical issues that may be preventing your acoustic guitar from sounding its best. And we're going to begin by talking about the position of your arm on the guitar's top. Now, the guitar's top is effectively like the speaker in an amplifier. It's the thing that vibrates and projects the sound forward. And if you put too much of yourself on it, for example, if you tend to play like this, or like this, or whatever, and you're really kind of crushing the guitar's top, or resting on the guitar's top excessively, it can stop it from vibrating. At its absolute best, the way the builder intended. So let's explore the effect of that now. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna begin by playing in my normal playing position where I don't have very much skin on the top of the guitar at all, and then I'm really gonna kind of hug it and show you what difference that makes. Let's take a listen to that now. The next consideration is going to be the position of your pick on the strings, specifically where you are across the guitar's playing area. We're going to start by playing somewhere around the sound hole kind of area, then I'll move it way back here and then way forward towards the neck. Let's take a listen to what difference that makes to the tone. And the last technique consideration is how angled your pick attack is, i.e., is your pick flat against the strings, or are you angling it at more of a 45 degree angle? I'm gonna progressively angle this pick as we go forward. So we're gonna start with a very flat position, and then we'll go to a slight angle, and then more and more and more angle. It's gonna get more chirpy, but perhaps also a little bit more rounded in the high end as we get more angled. Let's take a listen to that now. Okay, so now that we've excluded any technical errors that might be affecting the sound of your acoustic guitar, let's take a look at the most inexpensive and easiest way to change the way your guitar sounds, which is to use a different kind of pick. To that end, we've got five picks we're going to take a look at. We have two Ultex Primetone Jazz 3s. They're these little brown guys here. One is very well worn and one is fresh out of the packet, so we'll use that to compare the effect of the pick's tip. We also have two Tortex Jazz 3s. We've got a lighter 0.73 mil pick and then a more rigid 1.14 mil pick. And lastly, we've got the gold standard for strumming, which is a nylon Jim Dunlop 0.6 mil pick. Let's start by comparing the effect of the materials of our picks. So we're going to start with a Primetone Jazz 3, a Tortex Jazz 3, and then our nylon pick. Mm-hmm. And last but not least, let's compare the effect of a new pick versus an old pick. I'm going to use a very well-worn Ultex Prime Tone Jazz 3, and then we'll switch to a brand new one. Next up, let's compare the effect of pick gauge using exactly the same materials. So we're going to compare a 1.14mm Jazz Tortex to a 0.73mm Jazz Tortex. Let's start with the heavier pick and then we'll switch to the lighter pick. So some takeaways from those pick tests. First of all, as a rule of thumb, when it comes to pick gauge, a lighter pick is going to sound brighter and a thicker pick is going to sound a little darker and a little more focused in the low end and in the fundamentals of the tone. So if you want sparkle, maybe reach for a lighter pick. If you want a little more richness and a little more low end thump, maybe reach for a thicker pick. Now in terms of material, our Ultex picks had a little more chirp and a little bit more kind of pick clack, whereas the Tortex picks had a little bit less than that chirpy sound going on. They were a little more rounded in the high end. And the nylon pick, again, this is probably more to do with the gauge than the material, was super bright and super sparkly, but it was also quite difficult to play with because it's so thin. So that's a consideration too. Anyway, on to some strings. Now we're going to take a look at some different string materials and different string gauges supplied to us by our friends at Elixir. We're going to begin by taking a look at the difference between 8020 bronze, which is probably the most common acoustic guitar string. This is a really bright and focused sounding string, whereas phosphor bronze, which is perhaps the second most common acoustic guitar type of string, has a much more full and rich sound. So depending upon your application, if you're trying to fit in with a band and maybe you want that real bright, sparkly sound, maybe you're going to reach for one string type, whereas if you're a solo player, maybe you'll reach for another. We're also going to compare coatings. Now, the two different coatings we have here are the thinner nanoweb coating and the slightly thicker polyweb coating, which are in these blue packs here. So polyweb's gonna have a little less string noise, it's gonna have a slightly warmer kind of tone when compared to the brightness of the polyweb coated strings. And as if that wasn't enough, we're also gonna compare two different gauges. We're gonna do 10 to 47 when compared to 12 to 56. Now, up until this point, you've been listening to us playing 8020 bronze strings with a nanoweb coating, which is the thinner coating, and it's a 12 to 56 gauge. So we might as well start there. So let's take a listen, first of all, to the effect of our string gauge on the sound. So we're going to begin with just 8020 bronze, and we'll compare the effect of 12s to 10s. Next up, let's take a listen to the different string materials we have, specifically 8020 bronze versus phosphor bronze. And the way we'll do this is we'll do 12s in both materials and then 10s in both materials. And last but not least, let's take a listen to the difference that different coating makes. For this, we're just gonna use sets of 12s. So let's compare the difference between an 8020 bronze with the polyweb coating versus an 8020 bronze with the slightly thinner nanoweb coating. So there you go, guys. That's been a look at how you can manipulate some of the variables that are available to you with your acoustic guitar to improve and customize the sound of your guitar and get it just in the spot where you like it. Now, unfortunately, we can't take, say, a very small parlor guitar and make it sound like a dreadnought, let's say, by using these little tricks that we've discussed today, but we absolutely can refine the sound of a guitar that you're already fond of. So if you find a guitar that you really like the tone of, I really like this Taylor American Dream, for example, you can really get it in the zone, you can get it dialed in just how you want it, and you can also tweak that with a single guitar to fit a bunch of different musical settings, especially with picks, because you keep them in your pocket. So that's a really nice, easy way to tweak things from song to song, but from gig to gig or session to session, changing strings is another really great way to get your guitar's tone exactly where you want it to be for a particular musical setting. So there you go, guys. One more time, this has been a look at customizing the sound of your acoustic guitar. My name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive and GI Plus, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, be sure to check out the links that you can see right here for more videos on more of the same. I'm sure you're gonna like them just as much. Also, don't forget to click the like and subscribe buttons, which are somewhere down here, and this little bell icon, which is gonna let us notify you when we drop new videos. And you can check out the exclusive lesson platform, GI Plus, which is available at the link in the description. I think you're gonna love it.